As we begin a new liturgical year with the season of Advent, let us begin as always with the sign of our salvation and our faith. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. And therefore I ask Blessed Mary of the Virgin, of all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always on your account for the grace of God bestowed on you in Christ Jesus, that in him you were enriched in every way. With all discourse and all knowledge, as the testimony to Christ was confirmed among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revelation of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will keep you firm until the end, irreproachable, on the day that our Lord Jesus Christ, God is faithful, and by him you are called to fellowship with his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
There is no Christmas. If schedules permit, what about attending an extra mass during the week? Or if we feel weighed down by sin, there is always the sacrament of reconciliation to get us back on track. One last thing I might suggest during the season of preparation and expectation, the gift of sensitivity. Any way we slice it, this is a very busy and hectic time of the year. For many people, this is a time of year for much joy and happiness and goodwill. For others, for whatever reason, this time of the year is one of much sadness, stress, and loneliness and isolation. I am not asking anyone to repress their own love of the season. I love the season and all that it has to offer. I am only asking that we be sensitive to those who are struggling or going through a difficult time. Besides, when all is said and done, offering comfort, hope, encouragement, or companionship to someone who is going through a difficult time just might be the best gift we have to offer another person this year.
For the church held close by the shepherd of Israel, that all will be open to receiving God's merciful love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the peoples of the world and for their leaders, that they be aware of the gifts entrusted to them for the good of all, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and their families, friends, and caregivers, that they know God's healing, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the children of the world, that they will be safe, fed, housed, and loved, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community of faith, that we rouse ourselves to cling to God this Advent, pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lead the departed into the light of your dwelling place, including Walter Kaufman III, that they may gaze upon you for all of eternity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of the attentions listed in our parish book of prayer, and for all of the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord our God, we praise you for your Son, Jesus Christ. He is Emmanuel, the hope of the peoples. He is the wisdom that teaches and guides us. He is the Savior of every nation. Lord God, let your blessing come upon us as we light the candles of this wreath. May the wreath and its light be a sign of Christ's promise to bring us salvation. May he come quickly and not delay. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for the preparation of the gifts.